Shalom, my name is Raha Ernest, and we have been looking into those scriptures which will change the course of your life, scriptures that can turn your life around. And today we are looking into Psalm 68 verse 6, and this is what it says. God seats the solitary in families. He brings out those which are bound with chain, but the rebellion dwell in a dry land. There's a lot of things out there, but I'll talk of only two of them. He says here, he brings out those who are bound with chains. So there's a lot of chains out there. Could be chains of poverty, could be chains of ignorance. You can name thousands of other things that can bound people. But he starts by saying he seats the solitary in families. In a lot of other translations, says it seats those who are lonely in families. But loneliness is subjective. To me, it's got four levels. Because a human being is spirit, much deeper, soul, and then body. There are those who have physical loneliness. They're just by themselves, maybe because they are divorced, or maybe because their husband has passed away. And you can just tell them, get married to another one. Or you can ask them, join a church, or talk to your neighbor, go out there and mingle. That's physical loneliness, easy to solve. But there's another level that's called out of touch loneliness, or mental loneliness, whatever you can call it. Out of touch loneliness, it could be like you expect to be sent an album with pictures at Christmas, and everybody's telling you, join a WhatsApp group, be in technology. Join a Facebook group. That's where you see pictures of your grandchildren or your friends and all that kind of stuff. That could be out of touch loneliness, but that's not even deeper. There's emotional loneliness. That's much difficult to solve because you could be surrounded by people and you could be looking cheerful, talking to people all the time, but you're still lonely. But there's much deeper level which God wants us to start in the spirit, in the depth of our hearts. That is only can be solved by what Jesus has done on the cross 2,000 years ago. So, you know, in 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 14, it says, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. So you need to understand the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ. And you need to understand the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit. Those three who will always be with you, will never leave you, will never forsake you, is the first communion and first foundation for all of us to remove loneliness in our lives.